Hi, this is Chris for ComicsVerse. We're at New York Comic Con 2015. I'm here with Rafael Albuquerque, artist and co-creator of 8, American Vampire, and upcoming Mark Miller story, Hook. Thank you very much for letting us speak to you this morning.
Thank you, guys. Very nice meeting you.
So how has the con been for you so far?
Very good. I was very surprised about yesterday. That was the first day, and traditionally it's kind of slow, but it was packed over here, so it's very interesting to see that, and we are very excited about the whole weekend.
That's good to hear. So I read 8 recently, and I absolutely loved it. It was one of the best comics for me this year so far. How has the reaction been? What's the feedback you've gotten from the fans about 8?
First of all, thank you so much. Yeah, it was surprising, actually, because that was my very first time coming up with a story. And as much as I worked with Mike on it, it was my original idea. And I see myself as an artist much more than a writer. And sometimes I'm working on. So I was very surprised and very happy to see that how much people like it and how much people got into it. So that was really cool. I mean,
cool. And with the developing the idea, was there a spark of where it came from? Where there's so many kind of time travel stories out there. Was anything that inspired you to come up with this particular take on time travel?
Yeah, there's a lot of influence, even some obvious influence on it. So definitely Planet of Apes and, you know, 12 Monkeys. Even, you know, Jurassic Parks, in a way. All these movies and all these stories were part of how I got into the entertainment and how I got into storytelling and everything. So, in a way, that's my way to kind of pay homage to that, but try to put it all together and do something new.
And one of the things I noticed as well with the storytelling was the use of color in it. You know, like you have a color for the future, the past, the meld. How long was that introduced when you were thinking of the story itself? We're going to use color as part of the actual storytelling process itself. When did that come about?
Well, 8 was originally published as a web comic in Brazil. And to be very honest, I needed to do a page a week, and I was pretty busy at the time. So I needed to come up with something that could be done fast, but also it should be interesting and do not look lazy, you know. So I tried to do that, you know, use it as a tool for storytelling and a way to, you know, tell the readers where they are in time without constantly having to say, well, we are in the past, well, we are in the mail, you know. So I came up with this idea, and I really like it. I really like how it came up and how people noticed that. That was one of the really interesting reactions I saw online and everything. How people really enjoy the coloring.
Okay, that's great. So bouncing off 8 there, I'm assuming there's going to be a second arc. Is there any plans for when it's going to be released, or how early in the stages are you of developing the second arc?
Yeah, we are. Mike and I, we are working on the second story, and right now we are just cooking it up. I don't really know when it comes up, when it comes out. We are definitely working on it next year, so I'd say probably early 2007 or something, but it's probably too early to say when it comes out.
Okay, that's fair enough. just moving a slightly bit on from 8 there, I know that you've got a new book coming out soon with Mark Miller, where you're the artist on that. Could you tell us a little bit about Hook?
Definitely. Hook is... What we are trying to do is quite different than usual. We are telling a story, but we want more than anything is bring a feel. To that. That feel where we have every time we see an old movie like, you know, Back to the Future or Goonies or all these cool 80 movies that we essentially just feel good every time we see it, and we don't get bored by seeing over and over and over again. That's what we want to achieve with this comic. Hook is a story about this special guy who was raised in this small city in the countryside of the United States, and he has superpowers, and he does the good for this, for his community. He helps people and has this book where he tries to do a good action every day. Since he's such a powerful person, he runs fast. He's almost like a superhero. And when he eventually do a really good deed, a girl from outside of the city kind of tells to the press, and he becomes like a very famous person. Well, the story is pretty much about it, and that's how he deals with that, and how the city that was protecting him from the outside in a way deals with that. So it's a very different Millar, very different me, and something that we are both very excited about.
So am I. Can't wait for it. Just before we wrap up, just want to say, is there any other projects or anything you can work on that you can mention, or anything to tell your fans to keep an eye out for?
These are the projects I'm working on now. I'm working this Hook American Vampire. I'm still doing that. And hey, that's what's on my table right now, and it's a lot already. I'm always, you know, trying to think new stories, and I was trying to collaborate with cool writers. So I have something on the works with Rick Remender, but it's not something I can tell right now. So, but it should be announced soon.
Okay, that's great. Well, thank you very much for your time. It's good talking to you. Big fan.
Thank you.
So. That's Rafael Albuquerque, myself, Chris, for ComicsVerse. You can catch us on ComicsVerse.com. We're on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube. You name it, we are on it. Okay, take care. Bye-bye. Thank you.